Tāna whālawa. Welcome back. The general election is just 6 weeks away, and over the next few weeks, we'll be meeting some of our Pasifika candidates and leaders from parties with a strong Pasifika representation. And one of those standing is Samoan lawyer Fui Maono Ted Johnston, who's no stranger to elections. Having stood several times for central government, he became co-leader of the new Conservative Party in 2021, and he joins us now. Fui Maono, thank you for joining us on the show.
Thank you.
And I understand that you have a big announcement to make about your leadership of the new Conservative Party.
Yes. It's been an honour to have served during that time as a co-leader of the party, but and helped them to achieve nearly 3% in the best poll I've had in the last nine years. But there comes a time when you have to move on. In this situation, with all the little parties trying to get in parliament, it's a failed system to just collect all the votes into all these separate little parties and they all get wasted. What we need to do if we're going to get into parliament is to combine and pool all these votes so that we actually can reach parliament, because unless we get a voice in parliament, we can achieve nothing.
So what are you saying? Are you leaving the new Conservative Party?
Yes. What I've done is I've founded a new party called the Unity Party, and that's our slogan, Unity. Because what we need to do, it's very similar to a joint party list where that they have, for example, in Israel, where instead of all the wasted votes being put away by all these parties, they join together and pool their votes, because there is far more than 5%. And in our current system, in the last 27 years since MMP came along, not one single new party has ever broken through that barrier.
And have you told your leadership, the rest of the party, this is what you're going to be doing?
No. I've had to ponder about it for a while, and I know that this is the right way to do things. Because in all the different parties I've been in, I've been in this party, I have to always think of what is best for the people. I can't just walk through the ropes and pointlessly campaign and lead my people to just throw their votes away. It is not good to have wasted votes, because wasted votes aren't just those that are lost to small parties. It's also votes where you vote for big parties that do nothing for you.
So tell us about this new party that you're forming. What's it going to be called?
It's called the Unity Party, because that's what we stand for. We stand for unity of the people, because the main focus has to be the welfare of people. Whichever party I've been in, I've always been pushing the same thing for our Pacific Island people and others, for our welfare, because we look around us. We've never been in such a bad situation with regard to the cost of housing. We've never had such a bad situation. Go look at the supermarkets, a dollar an egg. The cost of living is the worst we've had. It's the least safe. How many shootings, how many stabbings are we constantly having? Underfunded police, underfunded health system, underfunded infrastructure. We need help, and we need people in Parliament who will speak for us.
6 weeks out, it's hardly going to have a chance, though, will it?
Well, the idea is we need to spread the message now. I've spoken to a lot of the other small party leaders over the last 2 or 3 years from all the minor parties. And the reality is, sometimes when you come in there early, they've said, it's too early. Then you'll get closer, we're still building. By the time you get to the election, they say, it's too late.
You've been involved in so many different parties over the years. Do you feel you've got the right credibility to be the person leading this group of all these different minor parties?
What it's done is give me understanding and background in it. What we have is a system that nobody's been able to defeat, the MMP system. 27 years, not one single new party came in. But by using the shared list system, and I'm working as well with another party, because mine's a new party. I'm not asking for your party votes. I'm saying, give me your party votes. I'll recommend with others and pool it in one place where we can share that. So I'm working with the Democratic Alliance. I'm supporting them. I'm not part of them at the moment, but what I'm saying is we put it all in one place and we get the leaders to work together so that all of us can get into parliament. And when we get into parliament, they can go back to their own parties. But it's the only way for all of us to get in that door.
What else do you want to say to our Pacific community that are listening about this new party, the Union Party?
This part of the Unity Party is not for us. It's not for me as a leader. That's why I was co-leader. I didn't care about who's running it, who's in power. It's all about helping our people. And so far, none of these parties help us. Take a look. You get a tiny little rise in your pay, but look at the cost of living skyrocketing. You need, in our Pacific people need people that will get in there and represent us, not ones who will sit there with their mouths shut. And while they may try, they always speak with a party line voice and are told when to open their mouths and what to say. I'll get in there and I'll say what has to be said.
Fuimano, thank you for joining us. Former new Conservative leader, co-leader, and now leader of the new Unity Party.
Thank you.
Pāwhitai lava.
Pāwhitai.